أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم In the name of God, the most compassionate, the most merciful إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم بعد أن أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد Praise belongs to Almighty God. We praise Him and we ask Him for guidance and forgiveness. And we seek protection in Allah from the malice of our own souls and the evils of our actions. Whom God guides, no one can lead Him astray. And whom He makes astray, no one can lead Him back to the right path. And I bear witness that there is no God but God. By himself, no associate to him, and I bear witness that Muhammad, peace be upon him, is his final messenger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, and we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, praise belongs to God who guided us to this. Had God not guided us, we would never have found the way. Praise belongs to God who sent down the scripture to his servant and made it unerringly straight. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in the Quran saying, You who believe, be mindful of God as is his due and make sure you devote yourselves to him to your dying moment. Believers, be mindful of God, speak in a direct fashion and to good purpose, and he will put your deeds right for you and forgive you your sins. Whoever obeys God and his messenger will truly achieve a great triumph. So, assalamu alaikum, everyone. Peace be upon you all. It's a pleasure to be with you all on this blessed day of Friday, blessed day of Jum'ah. And my dear brothers and sisters, inshallah, next week, next Tuesday, we will be celebrating Eid al-Adha. So I'd like to begin today's khutbah by wishing you all an early Eid Mubarak. May God bless you and your families always and keep you all safe and in good health, inshallah. Eid al-Adha is a joyous occasion where we as Muslims commemorate the end of the Hajj pilgrimage to Mecca and honor the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, Prophet Abraham, and his willingness to sacrifice his son, Prophet Ismail, Prophet Ishmael, alayhi salam, according to our Islamic tradition. When the Prophet Ibrahim, alayhi salam, Abraham, had proved his willingness to follow the command of God to sacrifice his son, God sent him a ram to sacrifice instead. This year, the Hajj pilgrimage and Eid al-Adha still looks a little different from years past, due to the pandemic that we are, alhamdulillah, slowly emerging from. As we all know, Hajj, the Hajj pilgrimage is one of the five pillars of Islam. It is obligatory upon every Muslim, every able-bodied Muslim, to perform the Hajj pilgrimage once in their lives, so long as they are physically and financially able to do so. Many Muslims save up for years to be able to attend the spiritual rite. Those who saved and planned to attend this year or last year may have to postpone given the heavy restrictions that were placed on the Hajj due to the pandemic. However, we must remember that if a person had the intention to perform Hajj but did not live long enough or was not able to do so this year for whatever the circumstances, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will still reward them for that intention as if they had performed the Hajj. Alhamdulillah, this year, many of us will be able to celebrate Eid al-Adha with the blessing of gathering with our family and friends, whereas last year, many of us could only celebrate virtually. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Almighty God for all his blessings, alhamdulillah. The COVID pandemic has also proven to be a test of patience for the believers. We all struggled with accepting the lockdown and the restrictions that prevented us from going out and gathering with our family and friends. We all adjusted to life virtually and socially distanced from one another. Now, we thank God that many of those restrictions have been lifted. However, let us please, please make sure to follow local health guidelines to keep each other safe in this last stretch of the pandemic, inshallah. The Quran emphasizes patience in the face of difficulty and promises ease after hardship. In addition to practicing patience and gratitude, I believe that we can all derive lessons from the example of Prophet Ibrahim, Abraham alayhi salam, and his obedience to God, by extending such obedience to include the acceptance of God's will. We may not understand the divine wisdom behind things such as the pandemic, but we have access to the prophetic legacies that are found in our Abrahamic traditions that we can implement in our lives to better our world. A perfect example of this prophetic legacy today is the udhiyah that we as Muslims perform around the time of Eid, where we perform or pay for animal sacrifices to help feed the poor and hungry. Islamic City is one of the organizations that provides this service, alhamdulillah, and may Allah reward them for doing so. Performing the udhiyah, especially during this pandemic, is so important because it is our way of helping our brothers and sisters who are in need by providing them with much needed food. This is a beautiful example of living out the sunnah of our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in our modern world, and of the sunnah being a force for good in the modern world. Let us also continue to give sadaqah, to give charity, especially around our holidays like Eid al-Adha, to help those on the margins who need our help and support. By doing so, we carry out the sunnah in our world, and we also garner God's blessings, inshallah. My dear brothers and sisters, in following the example of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, Abraham, and his obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we must try our best to connect that obedience with acceptance of God's destiny. Part of this acceptance is to have sabr, or patient perseverance, in difficult times. God is well aware of all the difficulties that we have endured throughout the pandemic, throughout the last year and a half. But if we are truly practicing our Islam, if we are truly, wholly, completely, actively submitting and surrendering ourselves to the will of Almighty God, then we should be able to weather any storm because Islam provides us with the tools to do so. There is a sense of freedom and liberation when we surrender to and trust the will of Almighty God. Let us also remember to read Surah Al-Kahf every Friday to remind ourselves of the example of Prophet Musa or Moses alayhi salam and Khidr. Khidr performed certain actions that on face value would seem unacceptable, and Prophet Musa alayhi salam spoke out. However, Prophet Musa did not understand the reasoning behind Khidr's actions until Khidr explained why he did what he did based on what God commanded him to do. Likewise, we may not be able to understand the divine wisdom behind certain things that happen in our world, but we must have faith and certainty that truly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty God, knows what is best. And this is something that is beyond our comprehension. And so we accept his divine destiny while striving to do good to the best of our capacity in this world. I think the words of Surah Al-Asr in the Quran are quite appropriate with regards to this topic, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Asr, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Wal asri inna al-insana lafi khusr, illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihat, wa tawasaw bilhaqi wa tawasaw bil-sabr. So in the name of God, the most compassionate, the most merciful, by the passage of time, surely humanity is in grave loss, except to those who have faith. Do good and urge each other to the truth and urge each other to perseverance or patience. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that the successful ones in this life are those who believe and do good and advocate truth and patient perseverance or sabr. The keys to success are belief, righteousness, truth, and patience. Let us all reflect on the ways that we can all live out these values in our lives, inshallah. So at this time, my dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment to lift up any prayers, any du'as, any supplications that we have to Almighty God and ask him for forgiveness. For indeed, God Almighty is the most forgiving, the most merciful. Bismillah, walhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi al-tayyibin al-tahirin وعلى أصحابه الغر الميامين ومن تبعهم بإحسان وإيمان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. In the name of God, praise belongs to God, and may his prayers and peace and blessings be upon the messenger of God, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him and his pure and good family and the righteous companions and those who followed them with goodness and faith until the end of time. Ameen. So my dear brothers and sisters, for us as Muslims in America, Eid al-Adha is also an opportunity for us to honor the legacy of Prophet Ibrahim, Prophet Abraham alayhi salam, as a means to build interfaith connections with our Christian and Jewish brothers and sisters. God tells us in the Quran, who could be better in religion than those who direct themselves wholly to God, do good, and follow the religion of Abraham, who was true in faith. The Prophet Abraham alayhi salam serves as the common link that binds the three great monotheistic faiths together. Let us use this example as a starting point to foster greater understanding between the believers of these three great faith traditions. I believe that such interfaith connections are also necessary in combating Islamophobia today. If we desire non-Muslims to better understand the true message of Islam and to aid us in fighting Islamophobia and prejudice and bigotry, then we must also understand non-Muslims too, so that we can truly be a pluralistic society built on neighborly love. In Riyad al-Salihin, there's a hadith in which the Prophet, peace be upon him, is reported to have said that there are two qualities which you possess that God loves, clemency and tolerance. Additionally, let us remember the command in the Quran when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْا إِلَى كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ أَلَّا نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَلَا نُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا وَلَا يَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا أَرْبَابًا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَقُولُوا اشْهَدُوا بِأَنَّا مُسْلِمُونَ. Say, O people of the book, let us arrive at a statement that is common to us all. We worship God alone. We ascribe no partner to him, and none of us takes others besides God as lords. If they turn away, say, witness our devotion to him, meaning Almighty God. So my dear brothers and sisters, let us follow the example of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, Prophet Abraham, and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And the words of God in the Quran that call us to promote tolerance and find common ground with our non-Muslim neighbors in the pursuit of pluralism for the benefit of all of our communities, inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us on this blessed day of Jum'ah, day of Friday, and on our upcoming Eid al-Adha, inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the ability to submit completely to him, to trust in his divine will, and to practice sabr in times of difficulty. We ask him to grant us the ability and the strength to follow the example of all the prophets and Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our hearts. We ask him to allow us to stand firmly for justice. We ask him to rid our world from the COVID-19 pandemic and to heal all those who are sick with any disease, and especially those who are suffering from COVID. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them a full and a speedy recovery. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to alleviate the suffering of all of our oppressed brothers and sisters anywhere in the world. We ask him to grant us peace in this world, for he is indeed the source of all peace. We ask him to guide our leaders in their decision-making, both here and around the world. Guide them to the truth and guide them to justice. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the straight path, to the sirat al-mustaqim. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to follow the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in the best possible in our world. Inshallah. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها وسلم تسليما. God and his angels bless you. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Oh God, send prayers upon Muhammad and the family of Muhammad, just as you have sent prayers upon Abraham and the family of Abraham. Indeed, you are the praiseworthy, the glorious. O God, bless Muhammad and the family of Muhammad, just as you have blessed Abraham and the family of Abraham. Indeed, you are the praiseworthy, the glorious. Ibadallah, inna Allah ya'muru bil adli wal ihsani wa ita'i dhil qurba wa yanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkari wal baghi ya'idukum la'allakum tadhakkarun. Udhkurullaha al-'azima yadhkurkum washkuruhu yazidkum واستغفروه يغفر لكم واتقوه يجعل لكم من أمركم مخرجا. Servants of God, God commands justice, doing good and generosity towards your family, and he forbids what is shameful, blameworthy, and oppressive. He teaches you so that you may take heed. Remember God the Supreme in glory, and he will remember you, and be thankful to him, and he will increase you in bounty, and seek his forgiveness, he will forgive you, and have taqwa of him, have God consciousness, he will make for you a way out of your issues, inshallah. And with that, my dear brothers and sisters, inshallah, we will pray 2 rak'ah of Salat al-Jum'ah through the live stream. So for those who would like to follow along, they can pray with us 2 rak'ah Salat al-Jum'ah. And for those who would prefer not to, they can, of course, pray 4 rak'ah Salat al-Dhuhr as they normally would, inshallah, wa aqim as-salah.
And please stay for just a couple of minutes after the salah, just to have a Eid salat announcement. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألم تر كيف فعل ربك بأصحاب الفيل ألم يجعل كيدهم في تضليل وأرسل عليهم طيرا أبابيل ترميهم بحجارة من سجيل فجعلهم كعصف مأكول. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لإيلاف قريش إيلافهم رحلة الشتاء والصيف فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Thank you, Brother Kenan, for that khutbah and for filling in. Last minute, we had a change of khatib on our end. And Brother Kenan very graciously agreed to fill in. And very appropriate topic as we approach Eid al-Adha, reminder for us about the significance of Hajj and our responsibilities and what we can do to maximize the benefit that we can derive from Hajj, inshallah. Just one announcement I have is we all know that the masajids are opening up gradually, but there are still a number of people in our communities who are elderly and still have health conditions. And then we have this, the Delta variant and other variants that are rising in our communities. So we will continue to offer these online virtual prayers. For Eid prayers, we will be holding the Eid prayers on Tuesday, July 20th, Takbirat, 8:30 a.m. And the Salat will be at 9 a.m. Our Khatib will be Dr. Aslam Abdullah. And you can go to that page. We have that linked on Islamic City, and we'll try and send reminders also to everyone if you are part of our webinar list, inshallah. So with that, I wish everyone a blessed Friday and a blessed Hajj season. And may Allah grant all of us the very best spiritual understanding of Hajj, even though we are going through these challenging times. And may Allah always guide us and keep us on the right path, inshallah.